Do we have any questions in the room to start?
Big win tonight, Liz. Let's talk about that big 3-point that Christy put up, put you guys up 8 about a minute ago.
Yeah, that was the dagger. That was the, you know, the Angels singing right there to put the dagger in the game. But, you know, I thought it was a great team effort tonight. Everyone, you know, we got the job done on defense, and that's what we were really focused on coming into this game.
I know you've been here obviously many times since you left here before. What's it like to come back here and play against this team?
Yeah, I haven't been back in Dallas since, you know, I played here. You know, I was sick with COVID the year before, and 2019 I had a little, you know, mental break when they came back to Dallas. But you know, it's always love when I come to the city. You know, I'm trying to maybe find some land out here, but you know, I can't do these Cali taxes no more. So you might be looking at me out here in the off season. But no, it's always love. You know, we got a lot of the girls are from the city, so you know, Hollywood was up. Oh, it was nice to see her with a big smile on the face, be back in the home city. But it's all love when I come to the city. So great to see familiar faces, and no, I love to see where this organization is headed. I love seeing BJ as the coach. She was my assistant when I was here, and these girls are young and full of energy. And I think, you know, a couple more years, it's going to be Dallas running this show. But, you know, it's all love coming back to the city.
One last question from me. Just on Christy, this past season, she was assistant coach with Dallas. Mm-hmm. Just your thoughts on that, and where do you see her future once her career is over?
Right where she is, you know. Just having her back, her vision and mentality of the game, it's so great having a leader like that, a floor general like that, playing like on the court. She's so calming. So is Necker for me. I love having leaders that just talk me through it. I love vocal leaders, and they bring me both of that. But you know, I think it's amazing Christy is coaching in the NBA and, you know, lacing up here in the WNBA. I think it's amazing. Shanae as well, you know, having another job and then being able to run it here in the WNBA, that's empowering for me. And I hope in the future we still empower that, and we don't disqualify players coming late to the league, even if they're playing overseas, if they're coaching in the NBA. I really don't want to see players, you know, missing out on the W just because they go to fulfill other purposes before they get back here.
Any other questions in there?
I do. This one's for both of you. Obviously, because I know you both talked about Kobe in the past. He's got his documentary dropping in a couple of months. Can you guys just talk about his legacy? And then also, how can you guys, build on this win tonight as well?
Kobe was like a real advocate. Like that's someone who modeled what it means to be an advocate for women in sport. Being in LA, you know, we kind of had a more personal connection, just simply being an LA team, but then also we were able to experience some things that people didn't with his presence around. And, you know, we just have to uphold that championship legacy. That's really what it's all about. And he was a perfect example of a role model for his daughters. I'm one of 4 girls too, so it's great to know that there's advocates out there. I always like to say feminism isn't exclusive. So to have a lot of strong male figures out there that are also like my dad that raise us to be empowered women, and then. I think building off of this win, it's all about focus for us. It's all about cohesion and us working each game, each possession to just be better. We've played in a lot of tight games. I think like a goal, I personally think a goal for our team is to win have a double digit win. And also too, you know, it's been a long time since I've won in Dallas. Coach Fred has history here, so winning for him tonight was also very important. And it's a great team. You know, it's a great team. I would say out of all the coaches, Vicky knows how to defend me the best.
Any other questions in the room? All right, go ahead to the Zoom, Eli.
I will go to Rashawn Haylock with Spectrum Sportsnet.
Hey, congrats on the win. NECA, these are the only colors you've ever worn. 500 franchise wins tonight. How much can you appreciate that, you know, having a piece of it for yourself and for the franchise as well?
It's a part of history, you know. These are, like, as a professional, these are the only colors that I've worn. These are the only colors I plan on wearing, you know. And I just love being a part of such a rich legacy, you know. We're an original franchise. There's so much culture with our team, and there's so much success with our team. There's ups and downs that I've experienced with this team. I've played with legends who have their jerseys hanging up, you know, and I'm just glad to have been a part of another milestone moment with the Sparks.
Thank you. Safe travels.
Thank you.
Thanks, Rashawn. We'll go to Jackie Ray with Nightcast Media.
Hey, once again, congratulations on this 500 win. NECA, I want to kind of piggyback on something you said about how Kobe really was an advocate, which you probably didn't see because we were watching the game. There was several commercials that really pushed having people watch the game. So I just want to ask your opinion as far as us as media, mm-hmm. how can we be advocates outside of just covering the game? How can we be advocates to get more attention onto what you guys are doing on the floor?
There's so many ways to answer this question.
Here for a minute,
girl. Yeah, there's so many ways to answer this question. I think when it comes to individual team media, having beat reporters is very important. I've been on this team when no one was coming, and then we won, and all of a sudden we had people that were covering us that knew nothing about the players on our team. So having people that are consistently there, same with the league. I personally think that we can have better TV deals. That's just my personal opinion. We appreciate the support that we get with what already exists, but it shouldn't be so damn hard to find our games. Like, it really shouldn't. It should not be. We have 2 ESPN games this year, you know?
I think 1 ESPN and 2 that are like ESPN 3.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, you know, thankfully we had a CBS game tonight. You know, it's all of that wrapped around representation. You know, right now I'm seeing 3 Black media here. I'm seeing 3 Black, as far as like pictures that I see 3 Black media on the screen. Having people who look like a majority of this league telling the stories of the women of this league is very important. We're not a one-trick pony. The WNBA is made of so many different players. So many different players. And telling the same stories over and over again is just, it's a disservice. So those are just a few of my personal thoughts. But I appreciate, even you asking this question is important. You know, I think for a long time, as women in sport, we've been groomed to go out there, perform, and not cause any trouble. And so a lot of times in media, at least in my upbringing, speaking my mind was never really palatable. It wasn't something that people wanted to hear. But that's over now, you know. That's over now, and now we have players who have, I mean, over 90% of our players have their degrees. Like, we know what we're talking about.
I'm not in that 90%.
Okay, she has life experience,
right?
But I mean, it's just like I said, you could answer this question in so many different ways, and yeah. I think it's good to ask the hard questions. It's good to ask questions of those who don't typically get the spotlight.
Yeah.
It's good to highlight stories that are not easy to find, mm-hmm. and it's important for representation to exist in the media.
Mm-hmm. Perfect. Thank you.
Thanks. We'll go to Michael.
Hey, good win, guys. Just like when you two have it going, you know, with the high-low, just how tough do you think it is for teams to defend, and how easy do you guys think you make it for your team around you? You guys had 24 assists tonight on 37 buckets. Just how easy was it for you guys tonight to you know, kind of get some buckets for yourselves and then get it for your teammates as well.
Go ahead.
I mean, I didn't think it was easy for me to get buckets tonight. That's not how I felt because they were crowding me. So like when my teammates talk to me and they let me know where the crowd is coming from, that's what makes it easier. And I expected that, you know. I always like stepping up to a challenge, but when we're able to get that synergy between the two of us, it's very difficult, you know, it's very difficult for us to, it's very difficult for our teams to figure out exactly where to stop, you know. I think the key to that really is just moving our bodies and letting the ball find each other and always looking for each other, just having that awareness. And as you can see, like by the fourth quarter, you know, we were vibing.
Thank you. Unless there's any others in the room, I think that's it on the Zoom.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Be safe, y'all. Good night.